What's going on, y'all? It's day three here at the Black Market, the final series of the Black Market Marketplace. It's your girl, KnottyFabs, owner of the Handy Consultant. I'm here with one of the seeds of the owners of the Black Market, and I'm super excited to dive into some of the things that he's been doing. Let's get started. You want to introduce yourself?
My name is Christian. I go by the name is CG.
Very cool. CG, I like that. So, is that your artist name?
Big CG is my artist name.
Excuse me. Big CG. Okay, that's cool. That's cool. So, when we were off camera, we were off air, we were kind of talking a bit about like some of the creations that you have. You name that you're a visual artist. You also like to do music, things of that nature. First, I want to hear about your visual art, because we didn't talk about that.
Never.
And then I want to hear a little bit about your music, because I know you did a recent release. So talk to me about your visual art.
So my visual art, I started when I was about no younger than like 5-6 years old. Just drawing out like imaginations, creating war, doing like stick figures.
It started with
the stick figures, then it started like creating.
Yeah.
Doing like drawing people's faces, get into details. Then
for sure.
It kind of stopped at one point because I lost a sketchbook of mine.
That must have been hard.
It was really hard.
That must have been tough.
I couldn't really do. I could, but it was just like my motivation wasn't there.
Right.
Then I started getting into music. Then.
At what age did you start getting into music?
21.
Okay. Alright, so that's like not too long ago.
So the thing is, my family is really big in music.
Okay. Talk to me about that.
And like big in the music scene in Boston, so it's like I've always been a part of the scene.
Yeah.
But I never really like made music because I didn't want to feel like I was like
following anybody. But
you know?
All along it's sitting here ingrained in you.
Yeah, because it's, you know, having a father that's a DJ.
Yeah.
He's a hip hop historian as well. He loves hip hop and R&B to jazz to Afro Latino music to reggae to anything.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm here. We are all jamming. Everybody, this is a bop. The whole thing, he's setting the vibe of it.
Nah, Pops is going crazy right now.
Yeah, he really is. That's what's up. Okay, so you named that you did a recent release. Talk to me a little bit about that project. Talk to me about the inception. We also talked about when you created it and like when you decided to release it.
It was two or three years ago. It was the beginning. It was literally on the beginning of COVID where I created the project.
Wow.
I was writing the project. And it was about a lot of the things that was going on in the quarantine.
Yeah.
And like really trying to make the best of quarantine.
Okay.
And being creative as much as possible.
Yeah.
And it was my muse, honestly. Like creating music is a muse of mine. And,
yeah.
And turned into a passion.
Yeah. So have you always been writing music, or have you just started writing music around the age 21?
So you know what's crazy? I wrote a song when I was a little kid.
Oh really?
But like it wasn't really a good song, obviously, but that, yeah, I guess I wrote one song when I was a kid, but
that wasn't really a thing.
I was a basketball player too.
Yeah, okay.
And I was good at basketball, so like I was.
What position you play?
It depended.
Okay. Are you that good? Is that what that is?
Yeah, I was pretty good.
Yeah. I like that. That's good. Okay, so like in terms of your project, you decided it was about 2 to 3 years ago. You decided to release it more recently. When did you release it?
October 21st.
Okay, what's your favorite line out of the song that you wrote?
I don't know if I have a favorite line.
Okay.
I don't know if I have a favorite song either.
Okay. You have multiple songs? What was the project?
I have
project?
Four songs.
On the project?
Five songs?
Yeah.
4 to 5 songs on the project.
Okay.
Different vibes, each song.
And you collaborated with some folks in order for you to do it, or did you do like
I collaborated with my three of my bros that produce and engineer. All
right.
And so, I didn't collaborate with anybody that wrote music. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to like just put me out there.
I like that.
Me alone.
I like that. Well, it took you 2 to 3 years to put you out there. Well, what was the hold up?
You're killing me right here, man. You've been killing me with this.
What was the hold up?
It was was a mixture. It was a mixture of things. It was life hitting me.
Yeah.
Also, I had a little, like, I was a little afraid of, like, what people were going to think of me.
Of course.
Just because I had family that made music. So it was like, it was like a hesitation a little bit.
I hear that.
At the end of the day, I was like, yeah, I'm all set. I'm tired.
It's time for you to share yourself with the world.
Yeah.
I really like that. The thing is, like, when I think about entrepreneurship or just, like, creatives in general that's really trying to put something out there, a lot of times we come up against fear. We come up against this idea that there's other people doing this type of work already. They may have multiple years inside the game, not sure if I'm going to come in and if I'm going to be strong or anything like that. But I can imagine you probably put something really amazing out there regardless.
It was good. It was, well, to my standards, obviously, it was all right.
But you're looking
honestly, I liked it just because it's something that, like, stands out.
In what way?
Out of anybody in Boston.
Word?
Like, honestly, anybody really right now, if you want to listen, like, there's people that you could probably, like, say I might be sounding like.
Yeah.
But,
Not really.
This music is like it's substance where it's like it's something that not many people have heard of.
If you could describe the vibe, how would you do that?
The vibe. It depends on the type of vibe. It depends on how I'm feeling.
Yeah.
Sometimes I be thinking I'm not spontaneous, but when I'm making music, I'm very spontaneous of how I'm feeling.
Okay.
Sometimes.
Okay.
Depends if I get drunk while I'm writing or like.
Okay.
Taking shrooms or something, or I'm like smoking weed. It depends.
Yeah.
But sometimes I like being sober when I'm writing. Like,
okay.
It depends. It really depends.
We were just talking about somebody actually before we keep going. Hold on a minute, because you just said something that triggered a thought. There's some folks that have named the experience when taking shrooms, particularly as creatives or anything like that.
Yeah.
How has that impacted your work at all, if at all?
No. Taking psychedelics has impacted me as a person, not even just my work. It's made me realize that, like, I'm in control of where I do, in my world, you know?
Okay.
So,
okay.
Like, psychedelics is not for everybody.
That's also something I'm hearing, too. That's not for everybody. Okay.
It's for people who are actually, like, really in tune with, like, I guess the Matrix, if you want to say it, quote-unquote the Matrix. But it's really like if you really want answers, I feel like shrooms can help you get answers.
I hear that that's usually the theme. Okay.
But it's all about surroundings as well.
Okay.
Surroundings and just like making sure that the environment is peaceful. Is that because like if you're in a, and that's life, but especially when you're in psychedelics, like make sure the surroundings and the people you're with are like,
it's gotta be the right environment.
You don't want to be overthinking anything. You don't want to be overthinking anything because you can get lost in a thought. It could be a small little thought. You can get lost.
Yeah. Okay. All right. But yeah. So talk to me a little bit more about your project and the journey and stuff like that. So it took you a little while to get your project out there, but it's out there now.
I was homeless. I was homeless 3 times, so it's like that helped me become an artist. And
you were homeless 3 times?
Two, three times.
2 to 3 times.
Yeah, so like that, being resilient in such a way helped me like create and get over my fear.
So you were homeless 3 times. So like, like around what age and like how is that
about
impacting?
18 through 25.
18 to 25. You had like moments where you were actually like.
Yeah, moments where I was sleep on the bench, or I was couch to couch.
Yeah.
For a while.
Yeah.
Until I had to like build myself up to get my own spot to, you know, to figure out, because like having Caribbean parents, they don't play no games. So it's like even when you do play games, you're not. I can't afford to fuck up.
Yeah.
There's no afford to fuck up.
So your family's from the Caribbean?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Can you name again? We already talked about this stuff, but I wanted to share with y'all too. So where from?
So my dad's Jamaican, but he was born in London.
Okay.
My mom is Guyanese, but she has 5 generations here on one of my grandparents' side.
Yeah.
Having the best of both worlds of like really having generations here.
Yeah.
and having the opportunity to have a parent that's not from here.
Yeah.
It was cool. It was really like, it was a blessing, honestly, in disguise.
Yeah. That's definitely a different experience overall. Yeah. Like an experience as a
parent. Trust me, my parents, probably my mom probably like takes more of the, she embodies my dad's like Jamaican side. So it's like she, and my dad's also Ghanaian and Nigerian.
Oh, okay.
I just Jamaican.
Yeah.
I don't really know that Nigerian and Ghanaian side.
Yeah, okay.
You know, love to Ghana and Nigeria. Yeah. I'll be there soon.
Okay, that's what's up. So what are your future plans? I know that we were having a conversation a little bit. You had some ideas, some thoughts. And as you're stepping into this world of creativity, but manifesting this creativity that actually lives inside of you through entrepreneurship, what's your plan? What are your next steps?
My next steps are to release my project that I just put out from SoundCloud to Apple and Spotify and all platforms.
Can they actually hear from you on Spotify under Big CG? How can people find you?
They can find me on
Spotify.
Spotify, on Instagram, SoundCloud,
right?
SoundCloud. Well, it's on SoundCloud. The music's on SoundCloud right now. And I'm going to be putting it out on all platforms very soon.
Very good. I like that.
I have a lot of other unreleased music that's just sitting there.
Yeah.
Marinating.
Okay. I hear there's an event in the works or something. I don't know.
Yes, you let me know. There's an event coming soon. Very soon.
All right.
You know, the details will be there soon.
I like that. So you've been around Black Market for a while. You've been here. You've been supporting. What does Black Market mean to you?
Well, for me, personally, it's my inheritance. It's something that, like, it's like it's a calling. It's something that, like, I gotta do. Like,
yeah.
it's in the blood.
Yeah.
It's something that, like, I feel like if I'm not doing it, I'm not really, you know, doing the correct thing.
Yeah. And what does it feel like when you're here? When you step into this space, what does it feel like?
That has different feelings.
Yeah.
It can get overwhelming.
Okay.
As a person that's looking, you know, helping my parents out.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not the only brother, but, you know, sometimes, you know, I'm the youngest, so, like, I'm the one that's probably the most capable, that I have the most time right now.
Right.
But.
You're the youngest of how many?
It's four of us.
Wow. What's up?
Youngest.
Cool.
Yeah, so it's an interesting feeling.
Yeah.
When I walk into it, I feel empowered.
Yeah.
Just knowing that my parents own this, it's just like very empowering.
That's honestly like it's a blessing. Like that truly is.
Me.
Like not too many families, you know, are able to like say.
Trust
this
me,
is
it's hard to explain because it's like
this
it's like
is amazing.
It's like,
it is empowering. I can imagine, like, bringing something, you know, this to fruition. That's overwhelming, supporting. There's a lot of work that goes into it, a lot of legwork that goes into
trust
this.
Me.
So, that's no joke.
This wasn't the first business. We're nonprofit my parents has created, so it's like, looking at this is really inspiring because, like, it's not the first one.
Yeah.
My mom had Diamond Girls, and that was to, like, help young Black women, Black teenagers to create their own business, to create their own makeup products and stuff. So it's like coming from that to this.
You've been around this a while. Then.
Yeah.
You've been around this a while.
Yeah, I've been around entrepreneurship and just like even though I still don't have my LLC, but it's coming.
I can't wait. I mean, I'm on standby. I'm waiting for that LLC to come. I'm waiting for that event too to come about.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I can't wait. But at any rate, it was a pleasure connecting.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Tell everybody where they can find your music again.
Well, you can find me on Instagram, underscore big CG. Underscore big underscore CG underscore. And you can find me on SoundCloud, big CG. Much love, you know.
Yeah.
You can find me in Boston, Roxbury, you know what I'm saying? At the Black Market, you know how it goes.
I like that, I like that.
I'm helping
that's
my
good.
Parents out, helping the family out, we helping the community out, we doing, like doing what we gotta do.
That's good you know energy, man? I like that, I like that. That's another one, y'all, another until next one. Time. What's going on, y'all? It's your girl, KnottyFabs, owner of the Handy Consultants, and we are here at Black Market. It's day 3 of the Black Market Marketplace, and I'm super excited to talk to yet another amazing entrepreneur. Why don't you introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is Anisha. I own One Dope Queen. I live in Brockton, Massachusetts. Most of my items are inspirational for women.
Nice, nice. I love that. We need that, to be honest.
Yeah.
All women?
Yes. It just depends on where I'm located at the time, or which women, but all women, actually.
Cool. 'Cause I did see a shirt that back here, and I love that. It's amazing. I think that's necessary. I think sisterhood, bond, and things of that nature is extremely necessary. I also saw a shirt back there that said, like, melanin popping. My melanin is popping. I was eyeing it. I hope there's one in my size, because that's exactly what it is that I want to get, to be honest. I absolutely love that. But yeah, so talk to me a little bit more about your business. Talk to me about, like, how did you start it? Why did you start it? Things like that.
So I started when I was on maternity leave. Wow. Over 5 years ago.
Okay.
I couldn't imagine just taking care of a child and not working.
Yes, I
needed to do something.
Yes.
And at the time, I was planning my wedding.
And at the same time.
I was, and I needed to get the gifts to the bridal party.
Right, right.
And I'm really, like, crafty, and I'm like, I'm not buying these. I can do these myself.
You made them?
I made them, and that's how my business started.
What?
It literally started from there.
Amazing.
But it has transformed so much because now it's just like, I'm trying to really just focus on women.
Yes.
You know, I feel like we've been through a lot through the pandemic.
Right.
And I don't think we care enough about each other, about ourselves. So I really just try to have as many, like, positive messages on my items, just so it's almost like a reminder.
I love that. I love that. I think, like, women overall, there's so many reasons for us to, or at least so many messages out there that really push us to be more insecure. And I think what it sounds like, that you're encouraging us and sending messages in order for us to be more secure within ourselves and things like that.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like we're already up against a lot.
Yeah.
And I mean, I think women in general, but if we have to talk about the Black woman.
Yes.
Oh my God, we are really up against a lot.
We got some work to do.
So it's just, you know, again, it's like a reminder.
Yeah.
Like, just remember, you are a dope queen. And we inspire each other. So it's just, I don't know. That's literally, like, all I think.
Yeah.
Me and my sister have all these plans for 2023 just to expand the brand.
Okay.
So.
You want to talk a little bit about expansion? What does that look like? You don't have to go into too much detail, but you can share what you can.
Well, my sister has a separate business, which is LBM Jewelry. We're actually coming together and blowing up One Dope Queen, so it's not just going to be apparel. It is going to be jewelry as well.
Wow, that's amazing. So are you guys, like, kind of partnering up or combining?
We are.
That's amazing. You guys are about to be a powerhouse.
Trying. So I think it's like we'll have our own individual projects, but then we'll have the one that we come together.
Right, right. Okay, very cool. So it's his name, Monique? Or it's like La Boutique Monique?
So it's La Boutique Monique because her name is Alicia Monique. And I'm Anisha Nicole.
Okay.
And my business used to have my middle name in it, but my business name has changed a few times as my business changed over the years.
Okay.
And now that's why I'm at One Dope Queen.
Okay. So when you say that your business has changed over the years, what do you mean? Like, how did it start? Like, straight up.
So it really was t-shirt, but I was doing, like, sports.
Yeah.
Like, it was just completely, like, who I was catering to has changed.
Yeah.
But One Dope Queen has always been, like that was one of the first designs I made.
Yeah.
And then every year, I would come out with a new One Dope Queen design. And then it's just like, why? This needs to be it.
This is it.
Like, I don't even need to leave this.
Yes. Yes.
And I'm like, no, this is, like, the idea, the vision,
like
the brand. This is
like
everything.
That.
So that's how I ended up here.
That's super dope. I love it. So how long have it, you said during the pandemic, how long would you say your business pretty much has been, like, going so far?
Oh, I mean, I started during my fraternity. He's five.
Hey, so 5 years.
So it's been 5 years. It's had three different business names.
Okay.
It changed drastically year to year to year. But now it's like, I got the vision.
Yeah.
This is it.
That's beautiful. That's really beautiful. So now you're here at Black Market. This is obviously not your first time here.
No.
Talk to me about your journey here at Black Market.
The first time I came here, my sister was already vending. She already had her jewelry business. And I met Kai and Chris.
Yeah.
And it was just like really an amazing experience because we don't have things like this. I mean, you could go to other states and other states have space for Black people,
yeah,
but we do not have that in Massachusetts.
Right.
And I mean, Boston, people think Boston is big, but is it really that big? Black
right.
Boston, it is that big, but
right.
do we show up
right.
and support the way that we should? We probably
right.
don't.
Right.
On a day-to-day, I tell people that I vend at Black Market, and they're like, what's that?
Yeah.
They don't even know. They've never even heard of
right.
Black Market.
Right.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
So when I first came, I'm just like, wow, this is kind of cool.
Yeah.
And then my sister was like, you know, you should come down here and vend. And then it's like, we became family.
Wow.
So every time Black Market has something going on, like,
wow.
I'm like, well, obviously we're going.
Sure.
We're going to be there.
Yeah. Yeah. I like that.
Yeah.
So it sounds like, so tell me, like, I don't want to put any words inside your mouth, but I'm hearing family in association with Black Market. What else does Black Market mean to you? And what has it meant to your business, too?
So earlier this year,
yeah.
I decided I wanted to host my own pop-up.
Okay.
And Black Market allowed me to have their space, and I hosted a Black History pop-up here.
Wow.
But we didn't do it Black History Month. We like
yeah.
waited a little
I
bit,
like that.
But it didn't even matter because it was still for Black
yeah.
History because it was
yeah.
called Black History 365.
Okay. Okay.
And
I like
that,
that
is what they've done for me. Like
yes.
they allowed me the space, and they helped me with my vision in order to do that
right.
because I had wanted to do it for so long,
yeah.
and I just was like. But Kai, like, really,
I like that.
She really helped with that whole process. And I ended up doing 3 markets here earlier in the year because I do it when they have their down season
yeah.
when they don't have them.
Right, right.
So, yeah, Black Market means a lot to me.
Yeah, no, that's a beautiful thing. How was your event? I like the, you know, Black History 365.
Yeah.
I love that so much. How was the event? How
the event
that go?
Was really good. We actually have already been talking about possibly doing another one.
It's in the works? Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
I want to hear all about it.
Yeah.
I want to hear all about it. That's super dope. I love that. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Is there anything, can you tell the people where they can find your products, things like that?
All right, so I'm going through a transformation, so the website is not together.
Okay.
But if you go to Instagram, you can find me at @1.dope.queen. And everything that I'm doing, I'm posting about. So once the website is together, I will let everybody know.
So, and I love our conversation today because one of the things that I saw in terms of the theme is that there's like this sense of partnership and collaboration and things of that nature between yourself and Black Market,
yeah.
Kai, Chris, and that to me is like super exciting, and I can't wait to see where you take your business. You have dope messages for women overall, and then even more so to dive even deeper for Black women
yeah.
and building up a sisterhood in that way and creating space for us to be more secure as a community. So thank you so much. Thank you for the work that you've done.
Thank you for having
and
me.
I can't wait to have you again at some point down the line in the
maybe
future.
I can have you here for the Black History Month.
Yes, that would be really cool. So make sure, let me know, give me
I
a
will.
Date, and I want to be able to lock that in.
Okay.
Yes, thank
I
you
will.
So much.
Thank you.
All right, y'all, that was that. Until next time. Hey, what's going on, y'all? It's your girl, KnottyFabs, and I am here at Black Market. It is day 3 in the Black Market Marketplace, final series. I'm super excited to yet again speak with another entrepreneur. Can you introduce yourself to the people?
Hi, everyone. My name is Jacqueline Cooper Fryer.
That's amazing.
Our business is Beard Love Premium Oils.
I love that.
Yes.
I love that. So wait, beard?
Beard Love.
Okay. Well,
yes.
Talk to me about what was the inspiration behind that.
So the inspiration is, there's 3 of us, 3 Black women, and we wanted a product that we could give to our kings because we know the struggle that they have in terms of moisture, and as a female, we want a man against our skin with that beard, but it's got to be soft, it's got to be nourished, it's got to be, we don't want nothing scratchy, and we know that those are some of the things that women would say to us. So the 3 of us, we each bring a different portion to it. I'm a barber, hairstylist.
Oh, wow.
My sister does the working with the people.
I like that. Okay. I like that. The
customer service.
I hit it.
She does our Instagram and all of
okay.
our media.
Okay.
She does that. Then our other sister, Gail,
mm-hmm.
she handles the financial part of it because that's her background. That's what she does in her day job.
That's
so God put this all together, and we're from Roxbury.
Okay, how did y'all come together?
Well, we've been childhood friends since sixth grade.
Wow.
So me and Angela, we danced together in the same dance company.
Okay.
Gail and I, we've known each other since sixth grade.
Yes.
So we're sisters.
Yes.
As far as anything else is concerned, we're sisters. So that's, we just came together with it. I was living in New Jersey.
Yeah. What part of New Jersey?
South Jersey and Willingboro.
Okay.
And came back home.
Okay.
And we started this full-fledged in the kitchen.
Yes.
Mixing,
wow.
Blending.
Wow. So what product did you guys start with first?
Oils and balms. And so we've added body butters for women because the women, we were finding women coming up and saying, okay, so
what about
you something for us? Yeah. So we was like, you got it. You got it. So we've been working on that. So we'll be coming up with a beard wash and a beard conditioner. And we have brushes and combs.
Okay.
Very cool. So we have a lot of fun with it. We enjoy talking to the kings and seeing how they like it, getting feedback from them. And it's been all love. It's really been all love.
That's beautiful. So when you guys ended up starting, how was it that you managed to get your product out there to people and things like that?
Well, we started with samples.
Okay.
So then what we did was we just went around, and like I said, I'm from, I lived in New Jersey. I'm from Boston.
Yeah.
Lived in New Jersey. Again, I'm a hairstylist and a barber. So I had a lot of contacts in South Jersey. So I just began to give it out to my fellow barbers.
Yeah,
I'm like, here,
good.
Guys.
That's
we
nice.
Was in a shop with 12 barbers. So I'm like, here, guys, try this. And they all loved it.
Yeah.
And one of our biggest supporters is my fellow barber, Demetrius, in South Jersey. He sells out. Like,
really?
we get him 24 bottles, and he's like, all right, sis, I need some more. I just sent it a week ago, bro.
This is an untapped market, though. That's amazing, because you guys are like, how long you guys been in this?
2.5 years.
Wow.
It's been 2.5 years.
2.5 years?
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And it sounds like things are going really well. Someone's selling out in a different state.
Yes, we love that. Our product is in Georgia, down in Atlanta.
Wow.
Again, New Jersey, New York.
Are you guys selling mostly inside of like hair salons and barbershops?
No, actually, it's by our website.
Okay.
People come on the website and they're just buying our product off the website. Here, with the black market, we started coming out here in the summer of last year, and it's just been great. Word of mouth, it's just been awesome.
So I'm glad that you brought up black market, because we're here and the vibe is amazing. It's been pretty busy today, which is fantastic, right next to the holidays. Tell me a little bit about how your experience with black market has been overall.
This has been an amazing experience in terms of the support and the love from our community. Like, we had a lady come by today and she says, I just keep saying to myself, black dollars, black dollars. So I just think, I'm getting goosebumps right now because the love that we get. And just to see everybody come out in the atmosphere, the vibe, and everybody's in such a good disposition. Even when they did the block party, like, that was amazing.
Really?
Oh my God, we had so much fun, so much fun. So, I'm sad.
Yeah, because it is the final marketplace carpet shop.
I'm sad because I think they've done something wonderful here. They've created a really good space for us, you know, really.
Yeah.
And then we get to go around and we meet other vendors and, you know, get to talk, and we purchase their products too. And I mean, it's just amazing.
Just circulate the dollars.
Yeah, yeah.
I love that. There was someone that I had on here that was talking about, I think it was Ujima. I think that was like one of the concepts.
Yes.
Where it was like group economics and being able to kind of, you were saying black dollar.
Yes.
Circulating the black dollar within
yes.
the community and like really building group economics here just in this space alone.
Right. And that's why it's so sad that, you know, this is the end thing, because, you know, I was looking to see that expand and grow bigger.
It's few and far between, especially here in Boston, when you see something like this. And for something like this to be thriving in this space like this, I'm wondering, what ways can we continue
it? I know.
You know what I mean?
I know.
Like, beyond just black market, there's like so much more, and so I'm really excited to see where we can finally take this. But can you tell the folks like where people can actually get your products and things like that?
Yeah, my card, sis. Because we have three different ways that you can hit us up.
Yeah.
We're on Instagram at beard_love_kings. We have our website is www.beard-love.com. And then we also have our email. You can hit us up at beardlovekings@gmail.com. And we are located in Roxbury. This is where we are. This is where we were birthed and raised up. So all of our products, our business is right here in Roxbury.
Yeah. So what's the vision? What's the long-term vision for you
the
guys?
The vision is to just expand it out from Roxbury and beyond.
I hear that.
We want to get mainstream. We want to be in the stores.
I love that.
We want to be in Neiman. We want to be in, you know,
and
this
you will.
Is what we want to do.
You will, Ashe. It will definitely happen. It definitely will happen. Thank you so much
for
joining us today.
We appreciate it. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much. Y'all, we just pulled up with another one of the sisters here of this business. Come on, talk to me about it.
Yes.
What is it that you want to share?
So basically what I want to share with Beard Love, Beard and Love. Love is the word that we want to spend. We want our men to feel complete when they use any of our products. Any of our products, because we know his image matters. And that's what we want to relay to all of our men, that your image matters. When you wake up in the morning, when you're out on the street, we want to make sure that you feel that Beard Love from
amazing,
us. And just to make sure that your day begins and ends with the love that you feel from us. We want to be in the stores, but we want to have our products be with you. We want to start with the shampoos. We want to go on to the conditioners. And we want to go on to the balms. So we want to be global. We see all of you guys, we see all of our football players, we see all of our backup players, we see all of our men every day, and we want to make sure we complete your day.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Listen here, you heard it here first. We want to see you wearing Beard Love.
Absolutely.
Is that right? I love that so much. We've been talking about uplifting and building sisterhood, but now being able to see their love between both black men and black women. We need to see more of that.
Yes.
We really do. So that's a beautiful
we love
thing.
You.
It sounds like there's messaging within that as well with your business. So thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you guys.
All right, y'all. Love sister, y'all.
Peace.
Hey, what's going on, y'all? It is your girl, KnottyFabs, and I'm here at Black Market with day three of the Black Market Marketplace, and I'm super excited to be here with yet another entrepreneur. Can you introduce yourself?
My name is Rita Mariel. I'm the owner and operator of Mahogany Expression. I've been open for about 5 years. What inspired me is that I've been an artsy person my whole life. 2014, I was diagnosed with a rare syndrome that left me paralyzed from the neck down. So when I had to learn how to do everything all over again. So when my hands started working, my mother brought my mannequin, because I do hair as well.
Okay.
You know, to keep waiting, keep my fingers moving. My nurse brought me a notepad to keep sketching. So I decided, there's twice that death was at my door. I'm also a breast cancer survivor. So I decided that I'm going to keep putting my talents out here. So that's what inspires. I love artsy stuff. I love love, and I love black people. And that's what I've been thinking about.
I love that so much. Listen, I'm smelling something good when you sitting here next to me. So what's the word? Is
I also create like body oils.
Nice.
I like to do body washes and body oils, and I sell metaphysical tools as well. So one of the things that I do use is a body wash that's like a cleansing but yet expediting body wash. So there's a lot of cinnamon in it. It's good for your skin, antifungal. And then I make a mermaid musk-like body oil.
Yeah.
So that's probably what you're smelling. I just had to put some on just now.
Yeah. So what is the inspiration behind these products itself? Because I'm hearing your story, and it sounds like this connection.
They kept me sane.
Wow.
Painting kept me sane.
Wow.
Learning about going through those health issues made me pay attention to my body more, which got me into food and vibrational food and how everything has a vibration, and even down to the crystals. I wanted to get more into making sure that I'm using natural products. So like I said, I blend my own body oil. Yes. I can tell you what's in it.
Yes.
I can tell you it's good for everything.
Yes.
That's the premise behind it, is what kept me sane.
Right.
And that's because I know what kept me sane. Yes. What I can do now is give comfort and solution to people who are going through the same thing, or trying to look to just you know be more, pay attention to their body more.
So we're about to enter the new year, right? And obviously in the new year, a lot of people are trying to harbor the right energy as they go ahead and kick off the new year, things of that nature. Is there any kind of vibration or crystal that harbors a particular energy that you would recommend right now?
Oh man. It will always be like a black tourmaline or obsidian or a jet. Any of those are onyx. Any of those black crystals are protection crystals. So I always start with protection of whatever it is that you're working on.
Absolutely.
Whatever it is that you're working on, your heart, your throat, your root, whatever, you gotta protect that love.
Yeah. Absolutely, that's beautiful. And so now you're here at Black Market. This isn't your first time at Black Market, right?
No.
So talk to me about what has Black Market meant to you and your business?
I had one pop-up before I started working here,
wow.
or started selling here.
Yeah.
And it was their second pop-up.
Yes.
So I'm as old as Black Market is.
Yes. Yes.
My first pop-up, wow. I was going to quit because I use a lot of brown paint.
Yes.
And so I had to pay attention to my demographic. When I came here, I felt home.
Yes.
I felt loved.
Wow.
I felt included. I felt seen. I felt accepted. It was just Kai's like mom.
Yes.
You
yes,
know what
yes.
I mean? So
yes, I hear that.
Yeah. So that they gave me the battery in my back to keep going. And then the people who come,
right.
I've learned so many things from just the people in the community,
right.
Giving tidbits on how to sell and what to sell,
yeah.
and just Black Market is just like the trampoline,
I
you know,
that.
The sturdiest.
Get you launching.
The sturdiest trampoline I've ever had, man.
I just see one of your paintings walk up out of here.
Yes.
I'm not gonna lie. I've been staring at one of your paintings all night right now, like all day, all
thank
night.
Thank you.
And it's a beautiful painting. I love
Speaking
it.
Of what I just said, that some of the community people give good advice and good gems.
Yes.
One woman came in and told, she used to manage her husband's art career. She said, once it's done, it's not yours anymore. And that has been the best thing. And that's really what creatives in general, once you're done with something, you create it and you're like, it's not yours anymore.
Let me tell you something, that's so powerful for myself right now, because I'm also a creative,
mm-hmm.
and I do paint as well.
Mm-hmm.
But I have all my paintings sitting in a closet.
No.
And now you're just saying that, and I'm I need to
those are for somebody else.
It's not for me.
No.
Wow.
That's supposed to be making somebody else feel good right
that's
now.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I needed that. Thank you for sharing
you're
that, Jim.
Welcome.
I needed that.
That's the purpose, right?
Yes, I love that so much. Okay, thank you so much. Where can people purchase your items and things
so
like that?
So right now, I'm switching websites.
Yes.
But you can find me on Instagram. Mahogany Expression, MahoganyExpression, on all platforms, but I'm mainly on Instagram.
Yes.
And in February, I will be at a storefront in Central Square very soon.
Okay.
So I'll have details on that, on my IG.
Yes.
I will be updating everyone on that.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Thank you
so much, y'all. Go ahead and give her a follow. Mahogany Expression, such a beautiful name,
Thank you so much.
I love that.
You have
amazing energy. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank
I really
you. No problem.
It.
I had to come down. I was watching
Yes. Hey, what's going on, y'all? It's your girl, KnottyFabs, and I'm here in Black Market. It's the third day of the Black Market Marketplace, and I'm super excited to be with yet another amazing entrepreneur here. Can you introduce yourself?
Yes, I am Lorraine Zatora, and I am born and raised in Zimbabwe.
Nice.
So I came here in 2000, I think.
I don't remember what year. Yeah, it was 2000. Yeah, so I've been here for a while. I actually don't live in Boston. I live in Connecticut.
What? You make a 2-hour drive to get here today?
Well, it's an hour and 35 minutes.
An hour? Okay.
All right. People say 2 hours.
I always think it's 2 hours. I'm not gonna lie.
No, but it is about 2 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know. That's who I am.
Yes.
My business name is called Kanga's Closet.
Kanga's Closet?
Kanga's Closet.
Kanga's Closet.
Yeah.
Okay.
I named it from the name derived from my middle name. Yeah, so my middle name is Kangan Miso.
Okay.
And Kangan Miso means something that makes you like forget all your problems.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, like something that's it's like a distraction or like something that just keeps you like wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the reason why I named it that, I wanted people to have a piece of Zimbabwe, you know, like have something that, you know, like every time you visit a place, you always, the last stop that you stop at is at the marketplace.
Yes.
So you usually stop there and you say, oh, I want to bring something to remember my, like, you know, my journey or why I visited this place.
Yes.
So that's why I named it that, and that's what I bring to everyone. I bring them like a piece from the motherland. You know, that, you know, something that you can say, wow, this is authentic from Zimbabwe. You know, it's not like it's made in China or it's like made over here. I mean, not like it's not good when things are made somewhere, but it's just like it's just
Zimbabwe.
Yeah.
And that's
so
powerful.
Yeah.
You don't hear that often.
Yeah.
You have beautiful products too.
Yeah.
Can you talk to me a little bit more about the products?
So I have like from different things. I have earrings, I have necklaces, I have one of them I have on right now.
Yeah.
And we just do different things with
the
women.
You say we. What are we talking about?
The thing is, my aunt runs a school that she works with, like, different women.
Yeah.
Like, mostly, like, women that, like, widowed or something. And she's trying to help them have, like an earning to take care of their family. So those are the women that I work with. So I wanted to see what can I do to help out with that journey. So I go and I purchase the stuff from them, and then I come back and I resell it over here. So that's the week.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Because honestly, we keep having, there's this like theme and conversation about group economics and building, you know, within the community, and you're taking it overseas. Like you're taking it past
like
the
it's
host.
Like importing stuff.
That's amazing. Like truly, like that level of collaboration is expansive.
Yeah.
It truly is.
Yeah. I mean, I owe it to the people because I'm here. You know, like I have to show the diaspora, like what is it that we are about?
Yeah.
You know, like what do we bring to the table?
That's
so
amazing. That's a beautiful thing. And you're doing amazing work. You really are.
Thank you.
Now you're here at Black Market, right? And how long have you been with Black Market? What has Black Market meant to you and your business?
Oh man, I've been with Black Market since they started 5 years ago.
Wow.
I walked in here like clueless. I kind of knew what I wanted to do, but I didn't know where to take it.
Yeah.
If you see, like I shared on my page the other day, my first table setup and where it is now is totally different.
Your table is beautiful.
I used to just throw things on the table and be like, here it is. You know, but like Black Market has given me a platform. It's connected me with so many people. I don't know how many people called like during the pandemic from Black Market checking in, how you doing, are you still going, you know, what's going on. So it's given me a community, a space to be myself, a space to come and showcase everything that I do. You know, I love the owners, Kai and Chris. I call them my mentors because they just constantly talk to me. If they say, oh, why don't you get this piece? Why don't you have them do this? You know, so it's nice. It's nice to have that that connection and just reconnect. And the energy in this place is just amazing.
It's so vibrant. Like, it's honestly amazing to be a part of. Like, I was planning to be inside of this space, but I wasn't planning to experience it in this way. But to be inside of this space and everything that you're saying is resonating for me right now.
Yeah.
Like, I'm feeling it. I feel like there's a sense of love, family, community.
Yeah.
And it sounds like with you being there from the inception,
you've
been able to acquire that, inherit that, and then grow inside of your business as well.
Yeah, and I have even, like, customers. Like, I have a... one of my customers, she just texted me, she said she'll be here before 5. She has 30 pairs of these. Are you serious? That's a major supporter.
Yes, and
that.
She's coming for 10 more.
What?
So, like, those are the kind of stories, you know, like, when people come to my table, they're like, oh, I have this in green, yeah. I want it in blue, yeah. you know. So it's nice to have that.
Yeah.
And just to spend my day talking to different people, right. and just, like, with the other vendors, you get to know other things, what's trending, what to do next, you know, what you should not do. You get ideas. So it's like, when you're in here, you just... It's just an endless, like, learning experience.
I love that. One thing I'm really big on is learning through experience. And it sounds like that's exactly the trajectory it was for you mm-hmm. here at Black Market. Yes. That's a beautiful thing.
I know.
And you came on here, you dominated, you showcased some beautiful products, and I absolutely love that.
I know.
Thank you.
I know. I always tell Kai, no matter where she places me, I'm just going to shine.
Yes.
My jewelry just, because I've been, like, right here.
Yes.
I've anchored it,
yes.
being, like, right here.
Yes.
I've been in the back.
Like
I've been
it.
In the corner.
I found you. I'm gonna tell you that
yeah.
right now.
And people
you.
Find me.
Yeah. I love that. So,
so much. I don't know. I'm sad that we're coming to the end of the. Even like usually around this time, I'm always sad because that once this one, this is like the last markets that I do in a year, and then it kind of dies down until spring.
Right.
But knowing that maybe next year they're not opening, it's just. It's sad, but I appreciate
yeah.
what I've gotten from this,
absolutely.
You know, and I'm just thankful that at least I'm able to take what I've learned and, like, just, you know, place it in different areas yeah. and grow some more, you
yeah.
know?
And that right there, that learning, your relationships, mm-hmm. they're timeless. They're absolutely timeless.
Yeah.
Can you let the people know where they could purchase your products?
Sure. I am on Facebook and... Instagram, and I also have an Etsy store. So everything is under the same name, Kangas Closet. That's K-A-N-G-A-S, and then Closet. So you can find me on all three of those platforms.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming on here. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Of course.
And giving me this opportunity to talk to the people.
Of course. And I'm hoping that we get a chance to connect again sometime in the future,
mm-hmm.
hopefully sooner rather than later, to just talk about your growth and how you're expanding.
Yeah.
Things of that nature.
Okay.
All right, y'all. That's
right.
Another one.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I had no idea what we were going to do when I was challenged by my husband to go out. And we went out one late night in December of 2016. We knew A Nubian Ocean was closing. We knew that nothing would ever fill its shoes. We weren't trying to do that. But we had the inkling and the audacity to come out into Dudley and look around. We even contemplated that space where A Nubian Ocean was, and I said, nah, it's not it. Then we went over to where Expressions is, and I said, no, this isn't it. And then we drove down here to 2136, and this was an empty storefront. I looked in the window, and I was like, wow. And it was all raw. There was nothing in here. No floors. You know, everything was just raw. I called the number. I got a call back the next morning. We drove down here to see the space. As soon as I walked over that threshold, I knew it was a space for us. Didn't know what we were going to do. Until 90 days later when we went to Senegal twice on the continent with downloads that directed us to move in faith.
Amen.
Went to Senegal, went to Gori Island where they had a holding station for Africans, for our ancestors.
Wow.
Saw a placard there. And it said, this is from WILD in Roxbury, Mass, 02119. No lie, we have pictures, we have receipts. We looked at each other. You can't get away from Roxbury.
Not even in Africa.
Not even in the continent with 2 billion people, with 54 nations, like, you just can't get away. The last day of that trip, after going, you know, Egypt 90 days prior, going to different marketplaces, going to support different small businesses. Same thing in Senegal, going to different marketplaces. I said to my husband, I said, baby, the space we have back home, maybe it should be a marketplace that's cooperative. And maybe we should call it Black Market. He said, that's dope. He said, let's go.
He did say, that's dope. I know what
you know. I did. I know, exactly. You know exactly what I said.
March 1st, we got back here. Boots on the ground. We're at the Haley House. I'm talking to Paul Goodnight. He'll be here next week, by the way. Paul's setting up.
Wow.
Okay. Talked to Paul. I mean, I talked to critical people. Still didn't know what this was going to be, per se, in the sense where I didn't know exactly what I was doing. I had a friend, although I will say this, I have done pop-ups before, and I have had my own boutique, and I've run retail. So it's not like this is just so far-fetched, okay? All right, and Lip Hop Cosmetics, yes, thank you. But long story short, I talked to my friend Anna Maven, who is hot and heavy with pop-up shops. She didn't want a partner, but she said, you know what? I'll do you a favor, and I will give you some of the vendors' names and things of that sort. And I started seeking vendors in the spring of 2017. This place was built by those vendors. In collaboration with the vision that we had, which stemmed from the energy of the Abdel-Khalak family. And from my knowledge, I grew up hearing that my bonus mother, Janaya Majid Janey, actually did the artwork for the sign for A Nubian Ocean. I grew up going, getting my coffee stockings there, because Black girls had to have brown stockings, and that was the place where we went, okay? My cocoa butter, because you know you had to have your skin right. Your incense, the dashikis, my family got, my mom, Phyllis Janey, got her first afro at their barbershop.
Their sterling silver bracelets.
There it is. Look, they still have them over here, you guys. In Yaqub's collection, okay? If you have a vision, I want you all to write it down and make it plain. If you have a vision of any size, I want you to write it down and make it plain. Then I want you to start to ideate and start to extract ideas from our culture and our heritage, ideas from your lineage, your legacy, and start to take a step out on faith.
Amen.
Write it down, make it plain, get your energy right, position yourselves for greatness. We didn't have it all together, y'all. This is not about perfection. This is about Black excellence and always striving to do better. That's all, okay? We've been very transparent whether this place has been filled with people, whether it's been empty with people. There have been times, and I have vendors here that can attest, Lorraine, the twins, Anisha, Alicia, they've been here when we've had literally, you know, 29 people come in. Today, how much have we had, Lertus? 204 people entered this space today. But the hardships trained us to be grateful for any type of situation that would happen, because that's what entrepreneurship is about, okay? That's what entrepreneurship is about. Community, this marketplace we have built on the backs of our ancestors, on the backs of our elders, for the sake of community. This is Kwanzaa. This is all seven principles in action, including the Ujima Mart, where Brother Donald the power within. He was one of the founders of that. That was once on 60 Warren Street in Roxbury. So to sum it up, I just want to thank all of my vending partners, and I want to encourage them. This brother here didn't know that this was our second to last marketplace, and he's looking for seeking more opportunities. What we want to do essentially is to be able to sustain our own business here and keep the space open, which is happening, but essentially place these businesses inside of the small business spaces of Nubian Square and beyond. But we take care of our own first, don't we? This is the historic Black community of the city of Boston after Beacon Hill in the South End. It's Roxbury and obviously Dorchester, Mattapan, Hyde Park. But we have to make an intentional effort to hold space for our visions and our dreams. And we have to be able to transfer those to the next generation. So it's important that you all hear the legacy story. And it's also important that you guys know that we ain't going nowhere. They're not moving me out. They're not moving us out. We're rooted and we're trying to make sure that we own this building. That is our goal for 2023, and that is our focus. And we can't do that without our collective community and those folks that continue to pray for us and those folks that come out and support. To my nephew, who stepped in for Brother Eddie, who had a death in his family. Antoine, thank you so much. You don't know how much it meant for us to call you this morning. And you stepped right in without hesitation to make sure that the families and the children and all of us who love Black Santa could have Black Santa. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. To Laertes McMillan, who always protects us, our Minister of Defense, okay? To my son Christian, who labors intensely to make sure that we can set up this space. To our podcast, Fabiola and her fabulous team, for always highlighting Black businesses, because we need that. And lastly, to the man of my dreams and the man of my reality. Hey, listen, if he ain't your fantasy, then who is? Just saying. I'm keeping mine. I'm going to let y'all know. Okay? Because I'm a fighter. All right? Listen, I'll fight for him. You know, because I know he's going to die for me. I'm going to die for him, too. But I love you so much. You are the father of this market. He has kept this place going many times when I wanted to quit. So many times I wanted to quit. Y'all don't know the tears, the blood, sweat, tears, and prayers that go into this, because this is intentional. This is not just, oh, we're going to do something. No, 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 no. What we not going to do, as Mayor Janey would say, what we not going to do, okay, is let our community just go into an opioid slumber, okay? We're going to be the beacon of light. We're going to be those who we've been waiting for. We are the ones that we've been waiting for, and we need to be empowered in this new year, okay? So as you all finalize your purchases, just be encouraged. We got one more Saturday. I need y'all to get the word out. I need y'all to make sure this place is packed. Make sure these vendors are tired and worn out by the end of the day, because they deserve it. This is hard work for them. And it's so much hardship that people don't know. They go through a lot, and we go through a lot together. And so we appreciate y'all, and I want y'all to keep Listen, the patrons of Black Market are the best. Y'all are just, ask every vendor, I always tell them, you better treat everybody like they're Oprah.
There you go.
You better treat them like they're Oprah, because that's who you are. You are Oprah. You are Gail. Okay? You are Michelle and Barack. That's who you are. You are royalty, and we appreciate you, and we know that your dollars mean something, and we don't take that for granted. So thank you so much for everything that you do. And we're going to keep it moving, all right? God bless and good night.